1절 말씀부터 13절 말씀까지.
It's verses 1 through 13.
말씀을 교독을 하도록 하겠습니다.
We'll have responsive reading.
오순절 날이 임이름에 그들이 다 같이 한 곳에 모였더니
And suddenly there came from heaven a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting.
마치 불의 혀처럼 갈라지는 것들이 그들에게 보여 각 사람 위에 하나씩 임하여 있더니
And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance.
그때 경건한 유대인들이 천하 각국으로부터 와서 예루살렘에 머물러 있더니
And at this sound, the multitude came together, and they were bewildered because each one of was hearing them speak in his own language.
여겨 이르되 보라 이 말하는 사람들이 다 갈릴리 사람이 아니냐?
And how is it that we hear each of us in his own native language?
우리는 바데인과 메데인과 엘라민과 또 메소보다미아 유대와 갑바도기와 본도와 아시아
Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belong to Cyrene and visitors from Rome.
그레데인과 아라비아인들이라 우리가 다 우리의 각 언어로 하나님의 큰 일을 말함을 듣는도다 하고
And all were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, What does this mean? But others mocking say, They are filled with new wine. Amen. Let us bless each other. Be at peace. You are the missionaries to save the world. Let us enjoy the inheritance of the desolate heritages. Hallelujah. Our past, present, and future. It is in the hands of Christ who has the power of the throne. Why did God allow our past? Why did God give us a time schedule of today? And why is God leading us to the future? It is so that we can become the witnesses where we proclaim the gospel of the Lord. So wherever you are, God will find you. And may this time be the time where you give all the glory to God and may you receive the greatest blessings. We have the Latin American ministers who are gathered here today with us. So after the core message, we had the ending service. And there are many people who have already gone back to their nation. And today and tomorrow, they will go back to their own nations. So it could have been a very uncomfortable time, but inside of the time schedule of God, they were led. And we were able to, our church, run the errands to help these people. And inside of prayer, all of our believers devoted themselves to help them. And let us give all glory to God. Thank you. Today's title is The Unstoppable Work of the Holy Spirit. Inside of our fields, we must enjoy this and experience this. Inside of all of the steps of the Latin American disciples, we must pray so that the work of the Holy Spirit that is unstoppable be upon our Latin American disciples. What was the mystery where the early church who received persecution had victory?
각인하고 뿌리내리고 체질되어야 될 부분들을 초대교회는 가지고 있었습니다.
The early churches had what we must imprint, root, and become a nature.
그 체험하고 난 이후에 초대교회 성도들은 단소리하지 않았습니다.
And those who were inside of that, the people of the early church, they didn't speak otherwise. They all lived in the same field, but they were able to view everything in a different manner. And they were able to go all in inside of what was important. And what was that?
실제로 핍박과 어려움 속에서도 초대교회는 그것 상관없이 로마를 살렸던 비밀입니다.
Inside of persecutions and tribulations, it was a mystery where the early people of the early church had victory. This is the important covenant that all of us must imprint, root, and become a nature. The people of the early church, they only look to only Jesus Christ.
다시 말하면은 오직 그리스도를 절대 해답으로 가진 사람들이 바로 초대교회 성도들이었습니다.
The believers of the early church, they were the people who held on to Jesus Christ as their only solution.
예수님은 구원의 축복을 제대로 누렸다는 말이죠.
It means that they have enjoyed Jesus Christ.
히브리서 5장 9절에 말씀하고 있습니다.
As the greatest blessings of salvation in Hebrews 5:9 it says.
영원한 근원이 되시고 말씀했습니다.
And being made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation to all who obey him. So Jesus Christ became the main source where we can receive salvation.
그리스도라는 사실을 묵상의 내용이었고 또 증거의 내용이었습니다.
So that is why the people of the early church, they were able to meditate upon the name of Jesus Christ and enjoy and proclaim. In Hebrews 3:1, it says, Therefore, holy brothers, you who share in the heavenly calling, consider Jesus the apostle and the high priest of our confession. And in Hebrews 12:2, it says, Look into Jesus, the founder and the perfecter of our faith. What do we meditate upon? And what do we rely on and look to? The believers of the early church, they were imprinted with the only solution, Jesus Christ. And they were the people who received grace from the kingdom of God. And they held on to that background and enjoyed. When we say the kingdom of God, what does it mean? It means the ruling of God and the indwelling of God and God being with us. And the early believers of the early church always enjoyed this. And in Isaiah 25:4 it says, He's a stronghold to the poor, a stronghold to the needy. In his distress, a shelter from the storm and a shade from the heat for the breath of the ruthless.
배경이 되셨기 때문에 그들은 그 어떤 핍박과 어려움 속에서도 승리했던 사실을 우리에게 말씀하고 있습니다.
So what does it mean? Inside of all of their hardships, they were able to have victory.
하나님의 나라가 그들에게 절대 미션으로 주어서 거기에 뿌리를 내린 것이 바로 초대교회.
The kingdom of God, that background became their root, and they enjoyed it.
그리고 초대교회는 성령의 충만 속에 주시는 하나님의 능력으로 하나님의 힘으로 승리하였습니다.
And with the power of the filling of the Holy Spirit, they were able to have victory.
어떻게 보면 그들은 사회적으로는 약자일 수 있습니다.
In society, they could be the weaker ones.
못하고 무식한 사람들이 모임이라고 할 수 있습니다.
And you can even say that they were the people who were unlearned.
가난했던 교회가
And even speaking financial-wise, they were very poor. But how were they able to have victory? What was the mystery? It is the filling of the Holy Spirit. Through the power that God gave them, they were able to have victory. The filling of the Holy Spirit, with that power, they were, that became their nature. And with that, they were never shaken, and they were able to even overturn Rome. So it is speaking of what we must be absolutely imprinted, rooted in nature. And to our Latin American ministers, wherever you are, if you hold on to this and imprint, root down, and make this your nature, that inside of all your steps, the works of the Holy Spirit will be given to you. And we will take a look at the work of the Holy Spirit. First, it is the work of the Holy Spirit that was promised in advance. This work of the Holy Spirit was already promised. The filling of the Holy Spirit that the early church received didn't just come. Already in the Old Testament, the filling of the Holy Spirit was shown in a figure and a shadow. Egypt, the King Pharaoh, he dreamt a dream, but nobody could solve that dream. But Joseph, who was a prisoner and a slave, came in front of King Pharaoh, and he spoke of the dream and even told him how King Pharaoh could deal with that dream. And this is what the non-believer King Pharaoh said to Joseph. It's Genesis 41:38. Can we find a man like this in whom is the Spirit of God? Joseph had the mystery that God was with him in Genesis 39. The Lord was with Joseph and he became a successful man. And in verse 3,
그의 주인이 여호와께서 그와 함께 하심을 보며 여호와께서 그의 범사에 형통케 하심을
His master saw that the Lord was with him, and the Lord caused all that he did to succeed in his hands. So with that, Joseph was able to overcome all of the environments, and he was able to overcome the problems of the culture and enjoyed and received the answers that was given from God. Samuel, one day he called David, and anointing him with oil, he prayed. And in Samuel 16:13, and the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon David. And David, with that, he was able to overcome the environment. And he was able to overcome the conflicts of other people. And he was able to overcome all of the problems of death. His father-in-law, Saul, tried to kill David. And even his son, tried to kill him. And But the power was given to David, where he was able to overcome all of that incidents. And there is a very important confession of David. The Lord is my shepherd, so I shall not want. Even though I walk through the valley of shadow and death, I will not be harmed. Why is that? It is because the Lord is with me. So David, who had the filling of the Holy Spirit and the power that is given from God, he was able to overcome all of that incidents. And there is a promise about the work of the Holy Spirit. On the Pentecost, the filling of the Holy Spirit was upon the Mark's upper room. And the fulfillment of the filling of the Holy Spirit that was promised was fulfilled in the Mark's upper room. And if you see in Zechariah 4:7, who are you, O great mountain? Before Zerubbabel, you shall become a plain. In Joel 2:28, I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. Even on the male and female servants, in those days I will pour out my spirit, it says. And again, Jesus speaks about the work of the Holy Spirit. He spoke of how the guidance of the Holy Spirit and indwelling of the Holy Spirit to the disciples in John 14:16. He will give you another helper and to be with you forever. 14:26 it says, but the helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you.
보혜사 성령께서 영원토록 우리와 함께 하시겠다라는 것은 성령의 내주하심을 말하고요.
The helper to be with you forever. It's talking about the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. And in John 14:26, he says he will teach us. So it is talking about the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
내가 너에게 말한 모든 것을 생각나게 하시는 성령의 인도하심을 말하고 있습니다.
And bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you. In Acts 1:8 it says, the Lord says to the disciples, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will become my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth.
예수님은 이미 성령의 내주와 인도와 역사를 통해서 초대교회가 예수 그리스도의 증인된 삶을 살게 될 것을 미리 약속으로 말씀하셨습니다.
So God has already promised the guidance, indwelling, and the work of the Holy Spirit.
우리는 여기서 하나님의 말씀의 중요성을 다시 붙잡아야 합니다.
So we must hold on to the importance of the Word of God. The work of the Holy Spirit will be upon those who hold on to the Word of God. And Hebrews 4:12 says, for the Word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of souls and of spirit, of joints and marrows, and discerning the thoughts and the intention of the heart.
응답하시겠다라는 사실을 말씀하고 있는 것입니다.
He's telling us that he will give us the answer and revive us through the word.
예레미야 31장 33절에 말씀하고 있습니다.
And Jeremiah 31:33 says. Let us all read together. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, declares the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it in their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Hallelujah. It says, I will write in their hearts and put my law within them. So to those who place the word of God inside of their hearts, God will show them the work of the Holy Spirit. So truly hold on to the work of the Holy Spirit through the word. Yes, God could work in many different ways. But the most accurate word of God, the fulfillment and the work of the Holy Spirit is God gives them the word and God fulfills that word. So I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you receive the blessing where you can place the word of God inside of your hearts. And God will absolutely fulfill the word that is placed inside of your hearts through the work of the Holy Spirit. Second, it is the work of the early church being filled with the Holy Spirit. In verse 1 today, it says, on the day of Pentecost. So that was the time schedule of God. Where the early church, people of the early church received the filling of the Holy Spirit was the time of the Pentecost. And here, the Passover and the ingathering was already inside of this. So these were the people who already held on to the covenant of Passover. And to those people, the Pentecost came upon them. And here, there were future was already given to their hands, which was the ingathering. So they became the people who harvest the spiritual crops. So I really hope all of our Latin American ministers go inside of this time schedule of the Pentecost. And may it become the time where you harvest the new spiritual crops through the filling of the Holy Spirit. So to those who held on to this covenant, wherever they went, they were able to harvest new crops, the spiritual crops, where the disciples were raised. So God already prepared the disciples, and to those who received the filling of the Holy Spirit, God placed those disciples to them. So God will absolutely place the disciples to you when you receive the filling of the Holy Spirit. So don't pray about anything else. Even the Lord spoke of one prayer. Only ask for the filling of the Holy Spirit. How did this work of the Holy Spirit arise? So in today, verse 2, it was like a rushing wind and like fire. So in verse 2 it says, and suddenly there came a heaven. A sound like a mighty rushing wind. And in verse 3, it divided tongues as a fire appeared to them. So what does this wind and fire signify? It is the work of the Holy Spirit that no one can stop.
Yeah, 160km, 70km 하는 강풍이 불어가지고 지붕이나라고 사람이 막을 수 없더라고요.
So even in Texas, there was a great tornado. Now, no one could stop that, and all of the windows were broken. And that's how strong the wind is. How can mankind block that wind? And like fire. In our nation, it's not that there is not that many of a case, but in America or Europe, once the mountain catches on fire, it burns for months. So no one can block. So when it says like wind and fire, it is the work of the Holy Spirit that no one can stop. The work of the Holy Spirit, no one can stop this. So it came upon them like wind and fire. It means that so in detail, it came upon the early church. So we hear the wind and we see the fire and we feel the fire. So in that detail came upon the early church. It means that they were filled with the Holy Spirit. And it came upon all of the people at the same time. So we must hold on to the mystery of the Holy Spirit. David went into the filling of the Holy Spirit through praise. So you yourselves find the way where you can go inside of the filling of the Holy Spirit. So 120 believers, they all went into filling of the Holy Spirit. What was the result? In verse 4, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. So the authority that these people received were speaking in other tongues. It means that God has allowed the disciples to be filled with the Holy Spirit so that they can make disciples of other nations. So the power of the Holy Spirit, it is connected with evangelism and missions. And inside of evangelism and missions, you're able to accurately hold on to the filling of the Holy Spirit. In Acts 1:8 it says, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will become the witnesses to the ends of the earth. So filling of the Holy Spirit, it is connected with relaying the gospel. It isn't to boast about the gift that was given to you. Yes, we can speak in other tongues. Yes, we can prophesy. Yes, we can show great miracles. But God didn't give us that so we can boast about that. All of the power and grace that is given to us, it is so that we can proclaim the gospel. Holy Spirit, it is the spirit of world evangelization. And at this time, we are able to surpass all of our thoughts and powers. So many people gather together to keep this feast. But these unlearned early church people, they were speaking in their own native language, and they were shocked. Are these not the people of Galilee?
성경에 보면 다 놀라서 신기하게 여겼다고 말씀했습니다.
And they were all amazed and astonished.
우리의 무능력과 무기력을 넘어설 수 있는
So the filling of the Holy Spirit is the mystery where we can surpass all of our powerlessness and helplessness. They were unlearned. The early church people, they were unlearned, and there were many women. But the mystery where they can overcome all of the powers and of Rome and the Greek philosophy was inside of the holy filling of the Holy Spirit. That is why we must receive the power that God gives. And with that power, we are able to surpass all of our helplessness and proclaim the gospel. And we are able to see surpassing the culture and even the languages because of the work of the Holy Spirit. In today's passage, the people from 15 nations, they heard the gospel in their own language, and they were all astonished. And other people say, are they not drunk on wine? But through the words of Peter, 3,000 people, they repented and came back to the Lord and was baptized. Many people say that it is hard to overcome the levels and the difference of culture. Yes, it might seem right. Yes, teaching our children with language and teaching them the culture, it might take many time. But the most effective way it is bringing in the disciples from that nation because they could have the culture and the language and teaching them the gospel, and that might seem easier. So even inside of our church, we are raising up the next generation missionaries. Yes, it's right. But there, we must not lose hold of something important. When we proclaim the gospel, because of the outer appearance, we could limit the power of the gospel with our own thoughts. We keep on saying other things. Or just enforce, oh, we just have to send them. It's not that. The power of the gospel must not be limited because the gospel transcends everything. The work of the Holy Spirit, there is no limitation. It transcends time and space, and that is the work of the Holy Spirit. That is why all of the things that limit the work of the Holy Spirit and the gospel inside of our thoughts, we must discard everything. Even though we cannot prepare the culture and the language, even though we have no background or our levels too low, when the Holy Spirit works, we are able to transcend and overcome all of that. It means that we must truly believe the work of the Holy Spirit. Evangelism is not something that we do. Evangelism, it is the work of God the Holy Spirit. So, holding on to the covenant and inside of prayer, we must see the work of the Holy Spirit. What is the reason why we must hold on to the work of the Holy Spirit? Right now, we all know it is the age of the Nephilim. Nephilim, it means where shamans are at work.
무엇인가를 우리가 아셔야 되는 겁니다.
And we must know Nephilim and what the three organization is.
전 세계를 장악하고 있습니다.
The three organization is seizing the whole world.
책과 모든 문화까지 다 3단체가 장악하고 있습니다.
They have seized all of culture.
나를 찾으라고 이야기합니다.
And they tell you to find yourself and you will become like God.
엄청난 영광이 있다. 그것을 찾으라 이야기하고.
And inside of you there is a great hero, so find that.
내가 나를 찾으면 결국은 창세기 3장으로 돌아가는 거예요.
If we find myself, then we just go back to the Genesis 3. Our master must become God. Our master must become Christ. And there, the forces of darkness is broken. Right now, the three organization, there are many people, the New Age culture has seized all of the people. Even the same in the Latin American fields. I haven't gone there. When I saw the churches and the temples, already the symbol of the Freemason, it is symbolized above the church. So the Freemasons has plowed into all of the fields and is seizing the culture. And mental illnesses will rapidly increase. Why are there so many people who are falling into drugs? It is mental illness. It is a spiritual problem, a spiritual disaster. What does Satan want the most? It is to break down our prosperities. Satan, they just, our prosperities just have to lose hold of the gospel. That is why he imprints other things. Right now, the schools and other people are teaching our prosperities, the things that the Freemasons are teaching. So I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you only imprint and relay the covenant of Lord Jesus Christ to our prosperities. That is why we are preparing the three-day weekend. What does that mean? Before anything else enters into our prosperities, we must imprint them with the gospel and make them gospelized. So on Fridays, we have prayer, time of prayer where they can receive healing, and on Saturdays, they could prepare their talents. And on the Lord's Day, they must find the Word of God that fits them and make the gospel be inside of all of the individuals. So what happens when you're filled by the Holy Spirit? We're able to find the eternal things. The mother of Moses, Jochebed, prayed holding on to the eternal things. Yes, she could be faced with problems. But Jochebed sent her son into the palace. Moses, as a murderer, was in Midian. But Jethro, knowing that he's a murderer, but made him his son-in-law. So it was a resolution that these people made. And same for the people of the early church, they had the resolution of holding on to the eternal things. And you're able to see that the early church had victory. I'll come to the end of my words. Missions and missionaries, they are the people to save all of the people and heal all of the people. So we have our Latin American disciples here. You, God has called all of you as the people of saving all of the people. People who do not possess Christ, they are all the people we must do missions. And all the people with Christ, you guys are all missionaries. But for this work, we need power. You must go inside of prayer in detail, the partisan journey and the guidepost. Jesus spoke of other things on the Mount of Olives. And that is the partisan journey and the guidepost. And holding on to that, in the morning time, have a time of peace and joy where you receive strength. And during the night time, you must come to the answer through the word. When the morning time and the night time takes place, then you're able to see many things in the daytime. And from this, you're able to receive spiritual strength. And I ask of the remnants, at least 5 minutes a day, have a time, have a summit time. Then the partisan journey and the guidepost will be made. And as a missionary to save all of the world, finding the mystery where we are able to save all of the people in the partisan journey and the guidepost, I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you have victory.
언약 붙잡은 기도 속에서 우리를 통해 성령 하나님이 역사하시는 것을 보는 전도 선교 속에 있게 하옵소서. 성령의 능력을 힘입어 내필인